Hello and welcome to episode 15 of Grow Like a Pro. I'm one of your hosts, Adam Bankers.
15 already, man. That's man, crazy.
You ruined my intro. I didn't even get to say your name.
Sorry. Jason Fleagle.
The Jason Adam, Fleagle.
Adam, yeah, the Jason Fleagle. The Adam Bankers.
It is pretty cool we're at 15, though. It's a nice, like, good number to be at. And to celebrate it, we are going to be doing a little... It's not off topic. It's just there's no guest this week. It's just us.
That's right.
In our studio, which looks a little different.
Yeah, so Adam, why don't we have a guest this week, actually?
Well, first of all, tomorrow in Columbus, Ohio, it is supposed to get wind chills, I think, below negative 30 degrees.
Yep. Crazy.
I mean, it's nothing like North Dakota, which has negative 60 or something, but yep, you know... Well, don't brag too much, guys.
Some of my friends in Canada, they're getting, negative... 40 to negative 50 wind chills. Ah, crazy.
It is absolutely insane. So yeah, we had a guest on that was supposed to come today, and Brett Johnson, who is an awesome guy, and we'll have him on in a few weeks or so, but we couldn't not have a show, so we decided to do it ourselves and talk about leadership and things. But you may notice that the studio looks a little different because we're actually in our conference room, because the remodel is just taking a bit longer than expected, as things usually go.
Things happen. But that's one of the things about leadership.
Exactly.
Adam. You got to be flexible.
Exactly. Yeah. No matter what happens, you got to find a way to make it work and compromise and do stuff and just make it happen. Mm-hmm. Don't miss a show. Never miss a show.
That's right.
That's what I have to say to everyone thinking about making a show. Just don't miss a show. Yeah. It's as simple as that.
I mean, don't miss a show for us as the creators, and don't miss a show for you guys as the listeners.
Exactly, exactly. But, before we jump into all of our talks and leadership and things, I want to remind people, if they want to be a part of the show, to send an email to hello@growlikeaproshow.com. Subscribe to us on YouTube. Listen to us on your podcast services, Apple, on iTunes, on Google Play Store, Spotify. Leave us a review. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter, and be a part of the Grow Like a Pro community. And, we're talking about leadership, and why are we talking about leadership today, Jason?
Well, I mean, one of the things that kind of got me talking about even doing that, because as Adam mentioned, I did this LNA leadership boot camp. If you're familiar with the Business Leaders of Central Ohio, Lance Schneider,
previous guest,
awesome guy, awesome group that he's been a part of, created. But he asked me to speak on this leadership boot camp, and we got to talking about why is leadership important to entrepreneurs and business owners in the first place. At the end of the day, you're leading something. Mm-hmm. as a business leader, an entrepreneur. You might be working a team, whether that's employees, whether that's happening working with freelancers that you're working with, strategic partnerships that you're working with. At the end of the day, all of that is leadership. So figuring out how to navigate those opportunities, those things that need to happen in order to get your brand successful, figuring out that process is really important. And in order to do that and lead other people effectively, you've got to be able to lead yourself first.
Right.
So how do you go through that process? So I did the talk at this event where,
he did wonderful, if I do say so myself.
Thank you.
I was wearing a cheerleader outfit cheering him on. I looked wonderful. Thank you very much.
It was pretty embarrassing. No.
I'm your biggest fan.
Thank you. I appreciate it. I mean, it's likewise.
Hey.
But yeah, I mean, I ended up doing a talk on the 10 ways to build and lead your brand to success. So that was the main topic of it. I've had, and we shared about it a little bit, Adam, a little bit about my story. I've worked with people like the John Maxwell Company, the Ziegler Corporation, Kevin Harrington from Shark Tank.
Adam Bankers.
Adam Bankers. Definitely good insights from Adam. Ron Greenbaum from The Basement Doctor and a number of his other companies as well. So I kind of put all of these best insights together, and at the end of the day, made it very actionable to be able to help people just like you to grow like a pro, to be able to improve your leadership abilities, to ultimately help you get to from where you are to where you want to go. So, I mean, without further ado, Adam, I think I'll jump into sharing some of the 10 ways to do that.
Yeah, definitely. And I also just want to say before we kind of jump in there is, being a leader, I mean, it's like what everybody kind of says, I want to be a leader. I want to be an entrepreneur. I want to do this stuff. But how do you get to that point? I mean, a lot of people, they say you're born with it. And in certain cases, there are people who have a propensity to it, but it doesn't mean that anybody out there listening can't be a leader and can't take a leadership role and grow their skills and grow their confidence and become someone that people respect and want to follow into battle. It's things like this and, you know, other videos and podcasts and all this stuff and amazing books that we, you know, we've talked about in the past that help you get there. But you don't just become a leader by just saying, I want to be a leader.
That's right.
Like, well, you have to.
I mean, Adam, we talked about it at the event. There's a huge difference between being a manager.
Oh, yeah. We're going to get into that too.
And a leader. So
a lot of experience.
Yeah. I mean, because you can be a really great leader, be a bad manager. You can be a great manager, but actually be a bad leader. I don't think so.
Okay. Well, we'll just talk about that. Yeah. Because we were discussing that too. Yeah. Is it's such a difference, because what kind of Jason was talking about is when you're a manager, I mean, people have to listen to you because you're the manager.
That's right.
I mean, it's plain and simple, or they may not have a job.
It's out of fear.
Yeah, exactly. A lot of times it can be, but the difference between a manager and a leader is someone you want to follow, you respect, you want to emulate, you want to be a part of the team and have them leading the ship. And it's something that I think people kind of lose sight of sometimes. And I just think it's such an important thing, because, you know, a lot of us in the past, I know, I'm sure you have as well, have had not the greatest bosses.
That's right. That, to say the least, that's being very generous.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of people in your past that you just don't, you butt heads with, you don't agree with, you don't understand how they're in a certain position in some cases, but it's and you don't want to waste your time with those people and emulating those bad habits and getting yourself in a dark hole where you think you're the problem, or you think this is how life is, because it doesn't have to be like that.
That's right. Well, I mean, I said it there. We had a panel discussion of some of the other leaders at this organization, at this boot camp, as part of the organization. And part of it was, you know, that desire that, you know, the topic of being a manager or a leader needs to be clearly defined,
right?
Because at the end of the day, why are you wasting your time, you know, working with what I would call a bad leader?
Life's too short.
Exactly.
Like, it's plain and simple. I mean, I know it's easier said than done. I mean, it's hard to just quit your job and go find a new one and stuff like that. Yeah. But you can take even small steps every day to make a difference in your life and be a part of a team or lead a team that you want by doing it, by taking that first step. That's another big thing of leadership. And sorry if I'm getting into your own tips and things.
Actually, I mean, that brings a very important point. I think we should talk about that before we get into these 10 points, Adam, is, you know, what is leadership?
Yeah.
So I'm curious to hear your kind of perspective too, because, you know, I did the talk.
Right.
But I want to hear your perspective and share it with the listeners and the watchers.
Yay for video.
Yeah, that's right. Video. Check out the video if you're listening on audio. Vice versa.
Exactly. Watch us twice. Why not? Leadership is when, what I believe is someone that, like I said, you want to go into battle with them. Yeah. You consider them, I mean, it may not be like a traditional friend in a sense, but it's someone that you trust, that you believe in their message, that even if they make mistakes, you know that it's because they were trying so hard and they believed in what they did. I mean, I think integrity is a huge thing, because the worst thing, especially going back to the manager and leadership discussion, is what's worse than a manager where you don't know like how they're going to act in certain situations.
Yep, that's right.
Like you try to maybe get something done on time, or you talk to them a certain way, or you handle a situation, and every time there's a different reaction and you're like, I don't know what to do.
Yep,
I mean, you want to believe in the leader's message. They have to be able to sell themselves as someone that you want to follow, that is able to make decisions, that's able to take, you know, problems and not let them bog them down and get all depressed. Because a thing that you talked about a lot in things too is the way leaders treat their employees are in return how they will treat their customers.
That's right.
Which I think is one of is such a great, it was a quote, right?
Wasn't that Stephen Covey, I believe, was the author of the quote. I'm doing it from memory. I can pull it up
once we go through it.
But yeah, the whole idea is, as a leader, if you need to treat your employees as if you were treating your best, highest paying customers.
Right.
Kind of paraphrasing a little bit. But it's that whole idea that you, at the end of the day, as a business or an organization, might be a nonprofit, you need to be treating your team very, very well. Better, if not at the same level as the best people you're trying to serve.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's so important to be able to do that. Otherwise, you know, why would you expect them to uphold the mission, vision, values of the organization itself if you're not kind of helping them get to where they want to go to?
Yeah. And that's the thing. I mean, we're not saying that you have to like pat everybody on the back every day and you have to be the nicest person. You can't be mean and be upset. There's a difference between that, because sometimes in a lot of cases, leaders need to make tough decisions and have tough conversations, and they need to tell you when you're doing something wrong, but give you actionable reasons why. Tell you how to get better, why you did something wrong, how you can grow, and not just say, hey, you suck. Wow, how did you do that? Or like scold you or do something like that. I mean, it's all about learning. I mean, we talk about this on the show all the time and we sound like a broken record, but it's one of the most important things is failure is not a bad thing in a sense. I mean, obviously it's bad when you fail, but it's one of the greatest learning experiences ever. And a good leader is able to take those failures and take them into a future success.
That's right.
To help their employees get to successes, help them get to future successes. And a leader is just, like I said, someone who's able to, no matter what is put in their path, they'll be able to find a way over it. And that trickles down to their employees.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, some of the greatest leaders are some of the greatest challengers.
Right.
Because they're pushing themselves, but they're also pushing the team to do better, to perform better, to push the organization to serve people better. You know, whether you're in the crowd of the Grant Cardone, Gary Vee kind of very blunt perspective, but they're still being true to who they are. Or, you know, more of the John Maxwell kind of more soft-spoken, more moral, ethical in their, I guess, media and promotion. There's a balance between, and there's a lot of leaders that have different voices, but at the end of the day, something that sets a very good leader apart is authenticity.
Oh, yeah.
I talked about that, you know, as one of the main points. A good leader, even if you just follow this one thing here, you're going to be a better leader. And that's leaders lead through authenticity, vulnerability, and integrity. So authenticity is being true to who you are, your character. You know, again, everyone has a different personality. So they're speaking and communicating in a particular way. With integrity, you've got to be doing the right thing. You know, the right thing for yourself and the right thing for the person that you're trying to work with on your team, the person that you're trying to serve maybe as a customer. And then vulnerability. Some of the best leaders that I have ever worked with, served, or have been learning from as a mentor, they are extremely vulnerable. They were the first to admit, hey, I don't know how to do this, but I can find someone who does. Yeah. We've got the team to be able to do it. Or, you know, they would cry because an emotion, something happened. They would be laying off people and they would be so distraught about it. And that being very raw and vulnerable with people, being transparent, sympathizing and empathizing with them, people will follow you like none other if you just do those three things. So important.
And you know, Jason, it's interesting because that is actually the basis when we started talking about Grow Like a Pro.
Yeah.
We had a conversation about what we want this show to be, how do we want it to do? And that was our conversation. We want it to be authentic because when you listen to someone, when you watch something, when you see something and somebody's fake, you see through it instantly.
Yeah, that's like, exactly right.
I mean, when I do the Hello at Grow Like a Pro show, that's me.
That's
is my life.
We are literally becoming celebrities just because of your wave, Adam.
I know, I get all these people now coming up to me and waving. It's so funny, but it's true because it was an authentic moment. I mean, Jason and I, we talked about what do we want? We need a catchphrase or we need something or whatever. But what the truth is it comes out when you are doing it. People respond to it. They respond to certain things you do, your actions. A great thing I think you said in your speech was you don't want to be the slave driver behind the employees cracking the whip.
Yeah.
You want to be arm in arm with them in the battle.
That's right. I mean, you are leading at the front.
Yeah, exactly.
You are there on the ground floor. One of the other leaders that was there at the event speaking talked about leading from the middle, I think was their way to talk about that. It's you're able to see sitting with everyone at the same level, people at the front, people at the back, how all the different pieces kind of fit together. So super, super important.
Yeah. And before we jump into your list, I do kind of just want to mention one more thing. You know, Lance's whole thing is the life jacket speech, which he talks about, which I think is so important because a lot of times, you know, this is actually, if we're being honest, my probably biggest weakness in my life has been sometimes I don't focus on myself. Mm-hmm. I don't focus on, you know, me at certain times to my detriment and sometimes to my family and friends where, you know, certain things happen. And, you know, Lance brings up this point, which is like, you have to put your life jacket on first. You have to your oxygen mask on first because it's true. Like if a plane is crashing and the cabin pressure goes crazy and there's no oxygen and you're like, I have to save my family. I have to do all this stuff. But if you're passed out, you can't save your family.
Exactly right.
So that's exactly why they say, I mean, it sounds like you're being selfish, but by putting yourself in a position for success, by allowing you to have a clear mind and a full heart and know what your mission is and being able to handle those challenges, you're going to be able to help people so much better than if you're trying to like help everybody and do all this stuff and go all over the place. And, you know, they asked us at this conference, what would you tell your past self?
Yeah.
And something that I learned in my life a lot is that there's difference between helping someone and enabling someone.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you want to help people. I mean, I love helping people more than anything. I mean, it's what I love to do. But at certain times, it gets to a point, especially, you know, with some family members or friends, it turns from helping for you just doing. I mean, get to a thing when they run into issues, they're just like, oh, Adam can take care of it, or oh, Adam will be able to do this. And you're not really teaching them or helping them, and it doesn't help anybody. It wastes your time, their time, and it just creates such a bad situation. But if you teach them how to do things, teach them to open their mind, teach them to grow, then you're helping everybody in return. So even if you think you're saying no, you're saying no because you're helping them in return.
That's right. Yeah, I always like to use the analogy, Adam, that if you think of yourself like a bucket with water, if you are constantly giving water out from the bucket, at the end of the day, you won't have any left for yourself.
Right.
So you've got to take that time to fill up the bucket and be very, very specific on how you're giving out the water. Because all of us have different skills and abilities that we can serve other people with. You know, there was one of the guests that was came up to talk to me after I spoke. And, you know, she was like, do you do any kind of volunteer work? And I'm like, there's a number of things I'm very good at. And I know that I'm very good at it. And I like to use my skills and abilities to help other people. That's why, you know, I volunteer on two different boards for nonprofits to be able to help them with strategic action planning. But at the end of the day, I know, getting back again to that bucket, that if I try to do too much, I literally do not have the energy to do my best work.
Right.
And again, being a leader, you should be excellent at what you do. You should not sacrifice the ability to do awesome work excellence. And you can only do that if you're very picky on how you're serving people and ultimately leading yourself well. Yeah. So,
because if you're not helping yourself, you're doing a disservice to the people you're trying to lead and you're trying to work with.
That's exactly as simple as that.
That's right.
Yeah. So, I mean, before we get into these main points, Adam, I've actually got a little info on, and I learned this from Zig Ziglar. Zig, I'll try to do an impression.
Such a good name. I like can't get over it. He's got it all down.
His story. If you check it out on YouTube, I think Goalcast did it.
We should do an episode on Zig.
Yeah, we need to.
That'd be cool.
Zig is a Southern, I say it's a Southern Baptist accent. His accent is amazing. So he would always say, you've got to be before you can do, before you can have. And he draws it out. And it's so amazing. It's like right on it. I mean, he uses a pause to be able to accentuate his main points. But so effective leadership. This is something I learned from, you know, studying his information when I worked on a project with the Ziglar Corporation. So, you know, effective leadership. Zig always said you've got to plan, prepare, and then and only then, if you plan, prepare, you can expect to win. So starting with yourself, and we talked about it, Adam.
Yep.
You've got to figure out, ask yourself a question, who are you? You know, how are you serving other people? And again, leaders lead at the front. And then plan how to do it. You got to take steps every single day. You know, life happens. You know, being a parent right now to a young baby and then making some time for my wife, things happen. But I know if I take steps every day where I'm moving towards accomplishing my goals, I'm making progress.
Yep.
And then preparing how to do it. You know, how are you equipping yourself with the resources, the mentors, learning information like a podcast, Adam, like the Grow Like a Pro show. You know, there's other awesome podcasts out there too.
Not just ours.
awesome host. Yeah, well, I mean, having that opportunity to build up other people doing incredible things, I think, you know, we've talked about it.
I mean, think how much we've learned from having all these guests on.
That's right.
And just talking and researching, because we're just doing it. I mean, absolutely. That's all it is. I mean, we didn't know what we were really getting into when we started this thing, but
that's right.
Every week you get better and you learn more and more and more.
Absolutely. So, yeah, and I mean, the final step, and we've talked about it before on the show, is you've got to take action. You can plan all day long, but unless you start to take action on it, it's not going to matter. Yep. So nothing ever happens until you start. So if you're debating, you know, especially being a leader, whatever position you're in whatever capacity, if you're debating whether to do something or not, figure out, go through that process to be able to know how you can lead yourself to be able to lead other people. So, Adam, why don't we go ahead and jump into the 10 ways to build and lead your brand to success.
I'm so excited. I've never seen these before, actually.
Yeah, right. Yeah, so, I mean, number one is set your brand apart. And I say number one because it really cements this at the foundation to be able to build yourself as a leader.
Because you are a brand.
Exactly.
I mean, that's as simple as that.
Every single person, whether they're an employee, you know, a janitor, all the way up to a multi-billion-dollar CEO of a company. You know, everyone is a brand, whether they like it or not.
Yeah.
You know, it's how do you portray yourself? So, setting your brand apart, I go through three specific things, and that's your brand story. So that's who you are, who your team is, why you do what you do, your mission, vision, and values. Your brand position is what you do and how you do it. So your brand story is your internal components, and your brand position is your external components, what you do and how you do it, how your solution solves the greatest challenge of your ideal customer, and then your brand journey. So your brand journey really is that experience or that process, Adam, that, you know, people move a potential customer to becoming a current customer, mm-hmm. to ultimately becoming like an ambassador or a raving fan for your brand. So how are you setting your brand apart? Very important. And then I love this quote, Adam, you know, people don't care how much you know until they know how much you care.
It's true. I mean, people buy from places they trust, from people that they feel are good people. Yeah. I mean, I think another person gave an example today is, if let's say you're a farmer, and you're selling carrots, and somebody comes in and your neighbor is selling carrots, but you have this disposition of you're angry or you're sad or you don't have a welcoming position, but your neighbor is very friendly and charismatic, mm-hmm. and open. I mean, who are they going to do business with? It's kind of as simple as that. And it's it's people want to buy from people they care about. I mean, when we talk about reviews and we talk about referrals, I mean, one of the biggest things, you know, for the Basement Doctor and for these companies that are asking customers to spend $10,000, $15,000, $20,000, you need those referrals. You need your friends and family to say, oh yeah, my basement and it was amazing. Yeah. Or they did, you know what, I went to this restaurant and it was fantastic. I mean, what's more valuable than that?
Exactly.
And that comes from when you show that you care and you're someone who puts forth that you know, persona of that is a good person.
Absolutely. Yeah. People do business with other people that they know, like, and trust.
Exactly.
That right there is a nugget that you can take.
Remember that one.
A growth tip.
If I've ever seen one.
Yeah, so point number two is learn how to make decisions. As a leader, you are...
Can I cut you off for 1 second?
Yeah, go ahead.
How do we make decisions of where to eat? That is the biggest question.
That's actually one of...
That is the hardest question of all time.
Okay, so in marriage... It usually comes back down to the most common argument is, what do you want to eat?
Exactly. I mean, it's crazy. I mean, that is like, if you could figure that out, please email us and let us know.
But. Yeah, please. That would be great.
Sorry, I just had to do that because that's what I always think of is, God, that's the most dreaded question. No, do you want for dinner?
Okay, so I actually, in the talk, I talk about how do you make a good decision? So maybe this might help you, Adam.
Oh, thank God.
So, okay, determine the outcome that you want. So
Chipotle or Benihana. Yeah,
exactly. Gather relevant facts and information.
That's like you already natural ingredients.
Mentioned the referrals and other information.
Good
on there.
Reviews.
Brainstorm a number of possible roadmaps that might work for you. What's going to happen if you go to Chipotle? What's going to happen, you know, if you go to a different restaurant?
Maybe we could go shopping if we go to another area that's around there.
Yep.
This is working.
Get opinions and feedback. So it might be,
Text your friends
or something. Yep, exactly. And then ultimately make the final decision.
We're doing it.
So, I mean, use another example. You're working with your team and you're trying to figure out, you know, something happened that you need to figure out, you need to navigate. Go through that process. Determine the outcome you want. Gather relevant facts and information. Brainstorm number of possible roadmaps. Get opinions and feedback. And then ultimately make a final decision.
Because, you know, as crazy as decisions are and as scary as decisions are, sometimes the act of an indecision can be even worse.
Oh yeah, far worse. I mean, it's, well, what is it, the quote of a person standing on train tracks, if you stay there, you're gonna get run over by the train.
That's true.
So you've got to be able to, you know, change is constant.
Yeah, for sure.
One of the things in our life, change is constant. So figuring out how do you navigate change in a positive way rather than a negative way.
Right.
Yeah, so number three is stay positive and motivated. So, you know, I shared a little bit of the things that I use to stay positive and motivated. One of the things I shared is, you know, I watch two particular YouTube videos every single morning just to get me motivated. Shout out to Lion of Judah. I actually mentioned them. I love their YouTube channel. Very positive, motivational videos. And then I also do a little bit of meditating. So very, very important for me to go through that process because, you know, leading other people and being a leader can be lonely and depressing at times, yeah. But it doesn't have to be. If you're surrounding yourself with mentors, friends who are kind of like-minded to you, who push you to become better, that's very, very important. Help you to stay motivated and positive. So, you know, a number of ways to stay positive are choose to respond rather than react to situations. Take a step back and pause and be like, you know, instead of reacting emotionally, how can I choose to respond to this situation with love, respect?